This is Shelley Dressel, and I channel El Bayon. He is one of the universal light beings and is an emissary of light from Arcturus.
Good morning, everyone. I'm Shelley Dressel. I channel the universal light beings. I'm part of crystallinetransformations.com and Goddess Light LLC. I've been feeling a lot of the energies. There have been a big solar flare that came in. This is a really powerful full moon. There's just so much transition. And there's also a lot of fear and things that are going on from people. So I just have been feeling El Bayon talking in the back of my mind. And I thought I'd just go ahead and see if he has something that he'd like to share for the rest of us. So I see my dog brought stuff in the house. Anyway, so I'm just going to do a little ULB mini, and this will be El Bayon speaking with us. Greetings. It is I, El Bayon. I come to you today to speak about the completion of what is happening upon the earth. How long have we spoken about this? How long has it been hanging over you and people wondering, when is it going to happen? When is the disclosure? When is the money going to change? All of those different types of things. It is also because this is the end of the time frame. There are many, many, many people out there that are really putting out a lot of fear. What do they call it? Fear videos or fear focus or fear intensity. And I just wanted to say to you, this is the time that is more important than any other time to stay in your power, to stay in your divinity. You know, through our group, those of you that have followed us for all these many, many years, you know that I have always, and all of the universal beings have always spoken about the fact that this is a positive transition for the earth plane, that this is something that has been written in the stars, so to speak, for many, many eons. And it is such a very, very, very important time for earth and humanity that I would hate for you to fall by the wayside here at the last minute. You can imagine that those that are, you have a win-lose dynamic that is always going on the earth plane. So you can imagine that those are going to lose are really fighting tooth and nail. They've never had any, they didn't mind who they hurt along the process in the past, and that is obviously still the case. But even more so, as they're here at the end of the line, they're just doing everything they possibly can to try to make you step out of your divinity. I've said from the very beginning that this is a spiritual ascension. And so what that means to you, there's multiple different layers of what that means. But what it means at its essence is that every single person on the planet needs to remember that they are a divine individual. They need to remember that they are connected to soul. They need to remember that as a soul sovereign individual, nothing can touch you. The illusion is there that many can touch you. The illusion is there that many control you. The illusion is there because that's what you have lived with. You've lived underneath for thousands of years, but in particular, the last 75 to 100 years have been particularly hard for humanity. So I would say to you, everything that you read, check in. Every time that you're getting ready to listen to something, check in. Every time that you're in conversation with the other people around you, check in. So what do I mean by check in? Breathe deeply, go into your heart center. You can close your eyes, not close your eyes, totally up to you. But when you go into your heart center, let go anything else that may be there. And then send a thread of energy, like you're sending a beam of light that goes up to you. It connects to your soul. It dead ends in your soul. And it may see your higher self. It may connect with, you know, other aspects of you on the way there. But just have that intention. I'm breathing into my heart center. I'm sending that beam of light to connect directly to my soul. And when it connects, those of you that are sensitive, you can feel whoosh. You can feel an expansion of your energies. You can feel like a trickling down of the energy. Some of you may see light, like there's a burst of light. For those of you that are maybe new to this or don't feel things as much, just have the trust. And that's very hard to do, because if so many people are like, that's not my reality, so how can I trust? I need to trust my reality. My reality is this. So if you can create a belief for yourself that you as a human are directly linked through a thread of energy that goes directly into your soul, it's there in every single human. And that cannot be broken. And it then leaves the physical body when that person's life is over. So you've got a connection, you've got a soul, you've got that direct link. And therefore, if you breathe into your heart, send it up to your soul, you're connecting. As you become more accustomed to this, you will begin to feel your energy shift every time you breathe into your soul. You will begin to feel that, I'm a little bit expanded now, because as you align with your divinity, it's going to move your energy field bigger than what it is now to accommodate for that higher frequency. And this is why I'm saying here at the end, breathe into your soul, feel the balance, the love, the support of your own divinity, and then you make your choice of what is your reality. There may be some people that you listen to and they turn out to be someone that's part of the gray hats, as you call them, or the dark hats, and maybe they were confused. Maybe you were confused. It doesn't matter. Don't go down that pathway of judgment. Instead, follow what is in your heart. Follow what resonates with you. And then if it changes day by day, you will be the one who is consistent. Okay, so those were that was my main message to you. That reminder of how to connect to your soul and to always listen to your soul. Because as you go through your life, there will be your ups, your downs, your whatever your experiences are. But at this time, the most important thing is to believe in your alignment to your soul. When you do that, you are also letting in more love. You will then look at the people through the eyes of love. You will then perceive, and when you read something and integrate something, you will integrate it through the energy of love. And this is what will keep you at a higher vibration and frequency. Yes, the end is here. Yes, the transition is taking place. It's been over with for several months now, and it is just now working its way through humanity. There are, what did I want to say? The thing that seems to be so much at the forefront is about the banking system, because of course, that which supports you in this reality, people are like, I don't want to lose all my money. I don't want to, again, I remind you, stay in the alignment with your divinity, even if your foundation that you follow goes through a massive transition. Even if the perception is that you've lost some or much of what is in your accounts, understand that give it 1, 2, 3 days, maybe 12 hours, maybe 24 hours, and it will be replaced with that which is in alignment with the quantum financial system. People keep saying, is there Nisara Jasara? Yes, there is, and this is what we speak about. People keep saying, when will my debt be wiped out? When will I get that money deposited? Some people are already receiving that. And for others, it will come within the next days, weeks, to a couple of months. So consider how so many of you have been following this path for what, 4 years, 5 years, 6 years? And here you are. We're talking days, weeks, and months. So keep your faith. Keep in the balance of your soul. And remember that love is the foundation of everything. Aunt Saluia.
This is Shelley Dressel, and I channel El Bayond. He is one of the universal light beings and is an emissary of light from Arcturus.